Hello students, my name is Prerna and I'm your EVS teacher. And today from your EVS book Enviro, we are going to be reading chapter number 15. Tell me one thing, have you ever heard of this saying, cleanliness is next to godliness? What does it mean? It means that if you keep yourself and your surroundings clean, you are doing service to God, or you are very near to God. So this chapter number 15 that we are going to study today is about cleaning your surroundings. It is about keeping your surroundings clean. So let us start reading this chapter. Chapter number 15, and the name of the chapter is Clean Our Surroundings. So let us start reading this chapter. Every day we throw out things for which we have no use. This includes fruits, vegetables, vegetable peels, paper, plastic bags, bottles, metals, old clothes, etc. All such items that we throw away as they are no longer of use to us are called as waste or garbage. Waste is also generated from offices, hospitals, factories, market, etc. So now we are talking about types of waste. The first is biodegradable, that is, which rots easily and it mixes easily with the soil. It is called as biodegradable waste. Leftover food, vegetables and fruits, fruit peels, natural fabrics such as cotton and paper, human and animal body waste are examples of biodegradable waste. Then you have non-biodegradable waste. So this includes plastic, glass, metals, etc. So they do not mix easily with the soil. This waste remains in the environment and can cause harm. Both type of waste should be handled differently to reduce their harmful effects on the environment. Different types of waste stored in waste bins of different colors helps us in this, and most of the country follow the color code for garbage segregation. So these are the two types of garbage cans that you would see across in your city as well. The green one is for the biodegradable. So the kind of the waste which can be, which can mix easily with the soil. The examples we've already discussed, like cotton is there, paper is there, or maybe the peels of vegetables and fruits. You are supposed to put only that kind of waste in the green garbage can. Then the other kind of garbage, probably like plastic bottles and metal cans, they are to be put in the blue garbage can. But do we really follow this? Most of us do not. So next time you go with your parents to throw the garbage, make sure that you're putting the garbage according to the color of the garbage can. Then you have urban and rural waste. People living in urban areas produce most waste than those living in rural areas. Living lifestyles of both areas is very different. Rural people or villagers lead a simple life. They reuse a lot of things. Villagers have fewer demands as compared to those who live in urban areas. Most of the waste generated by people living in urban areas is non-biodegradable, which can affect the environment. Like most of us have this very bad habit of throwing the plastic bottle. Let's say we've taken water, we've purchased a water bottle or maybe a can of a carbonated drink. The moment we finish it, we throw it on the road or sometimes even throw it in a park. But do you know the amount of pollution that causes? Ultimately, it is going to harm us only. Villagers collect their waste in compost pits and use it as manure. Then you have e-waste. This consists of discarded electronic and electrical devices such as computers, cell phones, batteries, wires, microchips, even pen drives and other gadgets. Like other waste, these items are also carried away and dumped in landfills. They contain harmful chemicals like lead, cadmium, and they just not cause pollution to the soil, but sometimes, you know, this kind of waste is also discarded in water bodies. You know what happens? Most of the animals die because of the disposal of such waste, of e-waste into the water bodies. So imagine how we not being wise in the manner in which we are supposed to throw the garbage, how much it is impacting the environment. So it's important to clean our surroundings clean, but at the same time it is important that we take care of the environment. Then we talk about waste disposal. The waste of garbage we throw into the dustbin is collected from our houses by the door-to-door garbage collector every day. These collectors are appointed by the local bodies or maybe by the colonies. It is also the duty of municipality to look after the garbage collection and disposal. Municipal corporation workers pick up these bins by trucks or dumpsters. Then now we are going to talk about what are the various ways in which we can dispose of the garbage. First is open dumping. Waste is taken away and dumped in the open designated place located at a distance from city or town. But do you think that is a good idea? We have seen large dustbins, maybe not very near to our area, maybe far away. Sometimes we see cows or buffaloes or maybe goats or maybe sheep around that area. So what is happening? We have this habit of putting the all kind of waste in one bag. And sometimes that plastic, you know, when the cow is trying to eat something, that plastic, it gets stuck in their throat, which also proves fatal for them. Then you have landfills. Deep pits are dug into the ground and garbage is dumped into them. When the pit fills up, they are covered with soil to prevent the breeding of insects and germs. So maybe we can put the biodegradable waste in such pits. Then you have incineration, is the process of destruction of waste by burning it in a big furnace or machine called incinerators. But even though it prevents the breeding of germs, it causes a lot of pollution because it emits a lot of smoke. Then you have composting, that is, it is a natural process that turns biodegradable waste into manure or compost. In this method, waste is accumulated, that is, it is collected in a pit, covered or left to rot for several months. After it decays, it turns into a manure. Again, we can use the vegetable peels and fruit peels in this method. Composting provides a way not only of reducing waste, but also converting waste into useful product for gardening. Then how do you control the problem of waste disposal? Here, the very popular theory of 3 R's work here. R, the alphabet R, that is reduce, reuse and recycle. So let us study the 3 R's in detail. First is reduce. So what is the first method? Reduce. It says that we must buy only those things we need and we can use. Every home can reduce the amount of waste or garbage it produces. Reducing it simply creates less waste. It is also best method for keeping our earth clean because it stops the problem at the source. By making less waste in the first place, there is less mess up to clean up. So if you reduce the usage of unnecessary things, what happens? That in the long run, you do not have a lot of waste to clean up. Say no to disposable shopping bags. Use reusable cloth bags. choose products that have the least amount of packing. Buy household things in bulk. Use what you already have instead of buying something new whenever possible. Buy liquid products that are concentrated. Buy only what you will use. Do not pile up things unnecessarily. A very common habit in our home that we keep on, you know, buying those. Oh, we might require it 5 months down the line, 6 months down the line. And what happens 5 or 6 months down the line? We are again searching for that thing because we can't remember where we have kept it. And what do? We then immediately go to the market and buy the same thing again. But what are we doing? We are collecting more waste for ourselves only. Then you have reuse. It means finding new uses for things that would be normally thrown away. A very common example I will give you here. The plastic bottles, the carbonated drink bottle that you get, you can actually use them as pots. You can actually plant, you can actually put plants in them, and maybe you can nicely color them, or maybe decorate them, or maybe you can use them as a pen stand. So with the things that we count as waste, we can actually make beautiful things that can be used as home decor. Many items can be reused. Purchase reusable disposable products such as mugs, dishes, cloth, napkins, and metal utensils instead of paper cups, plates, napkins, and plastic utensils. Use refillable containers like water bottles and soap containers. Sell or donate used clothes and toys instead of throwing them out. Use both sides of the paper when printing from your computer. Very important. And maybe you have printed something, right? And now you know that I would only require this for, let's say, a month, and next month I don't require it. What do? Use the other side of the paper, maybe to practice something, maybe to practice sums on it, maybe to practice question and answers on it. All right. And the third R is recycle. The more you reduce and reuse, the less you will have to recycle. Recycling is changing old products into new ones so that they can be resold. Cans, bottles, shoe boxes, newspapers, etc. can be recycled. Bottles and cans can be reprocessed to make new bottles and cans. By following the golden rule of 3 R's, we'll be able to save a lot of money and natural resources. Moreover, we save the environment from ugly hands of waste or garbage. So one thing I want to tell you today, you know, whatever you give to the environment, it will give back that to you. So make sure that you do not allow waste to be collected around you. And even if it is there, find ways to properly dispose it. The planet is in our hands, and only we can save it. Thank you so much.